Yo, what is going on YouTube? It is Get Scared here, bringing you guys an Advanced Warfare commentary here today. And yeah, it's been a little bit since I've uploaded. I want to apologize for that. I don't know, I just haven't really been feeling the whole YouTube thing lately, but hopefully, I'm not going to make any promises, but hopefully I'm going to be back for the next little while. I've been playing the shit out of this game though. Like, it's not like I've been bored of Call of Duty or anything. This game is honestly it's really great. I'm really enjoying it. This is actually going to be part one of my pros and cons video for this game. I do this for every Call of Duty that comes out now. It's just become a staple, I guess, for me. But yeah, this is going to be the pros. I'm going to start with the positive. There's definitely a lot of positives to the game, but there's also a lot of negatives, unfortunately. But all the negatives of this game I feel are patchable. And hopefully they patch them. So I think this game could definitely end up being like the best COD yet. But as of right now, I think it's probably close to Black Ops 2, but it might not be as good as Black Ops 2, because Black Ops 2 was just a really, really great game. Like, it was my favorite COD. But this game, it's definitely a really solid game. So anyway, I'm going to get right into the pros. By the way, this is just some Uplink gameplay, and I guess we could start off with pro number one, which relates to that, and that is the game modes. There is just a ton of great game modes in this game. Call of Duty Ghosts basically took a lot of the staple Call of Duty game modes out and added their own game modes, which pretty much were all shit. Like, Blitz was an awful game type. What else did they do? They did Search and Rescue. I'm pretty sure Search and Rescue is in this game, though, and it's not really my favorite game type, but I don't know. I've never really played it, to be honest, but it doesn't seem like it's that great. But the game modes that they added in this game are Uplink and Momentum, and both of those game types are really, really fun and just all around just great game types. So Uplink, it's kind of like Blitz, but it's just like, it's got a much better dynamic to it. It's a lot less fluky like Blitz was, so it's a lot better for competitive as well, and it's just a great game type. To be honest, I really suck at it, honestly. Like, I tried scoring points, and I can't do it. So what I like to do in this game type is just kind of go in their spawn and just try and slay them and let my teammates do the objective work, which doesn't always work out because I seem to get some shitty teammates in this game a lot of the time. But yeah, and then, of course, Momentum. That is just that game type. It seems like it's kind of like the chill game type of this game, where like people don't like necessarily care all that much when they're playing. It's just more for fun. It's kind of like, it reminds me a lot of Drop Zone, which I'm kind of disappointed they didn't bring that game back, because that was definitely my favorite game type in like MW3. And I know it wasn't Ghost, but I didn't really play Ghost, but it was just a really like chill and fun game type to play, and I really wish they had it. But Momentum is pretty similar to it in the sense that it kind of changes. It's kind of like Drop Zone, actually. But I guess Hardpoint's like that as well. But Hardpoint is pretty competitive. But I'm really glad they brought Hardpoint back as well, because I really enjoy that game type, despite the fact that it's pretty competitive and generally the competition in it is pretty good. Pretty good players, so it's kind of harder to drop a really good game. But it's still a lot of fun to play and watch. I don't know, I was playing Hardpoint like all day today, and I think I lost about 50% of my matches, but every single match I was just getting so much XP, it was crazy. But I just ended up with like the worst teammates in the world, holy crap. But anyways, so yeah, next pro to this game, in my opinion, is the exo movement. There's just a lot of innovation with these movements. And I know people will say they copied Titanfall or they copied Destiny. Now, I personally never played Titanfall. I did play Destiny though, and the mechanics are nothing like Destiny's, and they don't really look like Titanfall's that much. I mean, like, just judging from the gameplay I've seen, this game doesn't really look like Titanfall, so I don't know, I think those are some false allegations. And of course, I mean, like, every Call of Duty before this was the same, and now that they've actually changed it up, people are accusing it for still copying. So I don't really get that, but yeah, I'm really enjoying the new mechanics. I mean, I don't know if I'd want this for every Call of Duty. Like, I kind of want the next COD to actually be a past game, and I kind of want, like, back to normal. But, like, you know, maybe every other year if they did a futuristic COD with, like, this kind of movement mechanic, I think that would be really cool. But, yeah, I'm really enjoying it. It's really cool to juke out people with double jumps and stuff. Like, it's kind of like how you could do that in Destiny, but I think it's a lot better than Destiny's mechanics, to be honest. At least in the sense that it feels faster than Destiny. Like, I actually tried playing Destiny the other day, and that game just felt really fucking slow. But yeah, this game, it's super fast paced, which is another huge pro to it. Just completely different than Ghost. This game is like the polar opposite of Ghost. So that's just a great thing on its own, because Ghost was like the worst game ever. Another positive to this game is the maps. The maps feel a lot like Black Ops 2 maps and look a lot like Black Ops 2 maps. The graphics are just like really, really great. Like the colors and stuff, they look awesome, just like Black Ops 2, except obviously the graphics are better because this is a next-gen game. I'm playing on the PS4, and I know it looks really good on the Xbox One as well. Unfortunately, if you're playing it on an older generation console, it really doesn't look that good. Like, I've seen some video footage of Xbox 360 gameplay, and it looks pretty shitty, to be honest. But on next-gen console, which is where most people are playing it, it looks really, really nice. So I'm really happy about that. And like I said, the maps look a lot like Black Ops 2 maps. A lot of the maps might even remind you of Black Ops 2 maps. Like this map right here, Retreat, it reminds me a lot of Raid, like just this whole like style to it. Then another map, Terrace. I honestly really don't like that map, but it reminds me a lot of Plaza, which is cool because Plaza was a good map. There's some other maps as well that remind me of Black Ops 2 maps. I forget what it's called, but it's like it's raining and it's like kind of like I think it's like an oil rig in the middle of the ocean or something. I think it's called Ascend. It might be called Ascend. I don't know. But it reminds me of Uplink from Black Ops 2 because it's like raining and it's like a facility. And it's just, it's really cool. I really like the maps in this game. Another huge pro is, of course, the score streaks. I'm really happy they brought that back from Black Ops 2. You get rewarded for playing the objectives. And although the score streaks in this game kind of suck, I find that I've been doing pretty well running the bombing run. That seems to be the best streak, and the UAV, even though a lot of people run low profile in this game. Those streaks are pretty good, and obviously you get rewarded for playing the objective, which is amazing. I mean, in my opinion, you should get maybe like 100 points for a kill rather than just 50, because score streaks do seem pretty hard to get still. I don't know. I think it's still good. I'm glad that they're not like ridiculously easy to get. Like Black Ops 2, I think they might have been too easy to get. Like to get a UAV in Black Ops 2, it was like capture a hard point and kill someone and that's it basically. But I'm really happy with this game so far. There's definitely some things they need to change and nerf, and I'll get into that in my next com. But other than that, obviously, there's just like a bunch of Black Ops 2 inspiration. I'm really happy they brought back the medals. It was always cool to just see medals pop up when you get a kill and you see like 6 medals pop up because you like got a kill in a hard point and you like killed him after he killed one of your teammates. And that's just always really cool. And then like the Bloodthirsties, the Merciless medal. I think it's not a nuclear medal in this game. It's a vicious medal. And then, of course, there's the DNA bomb as well, which is quite the challenge to get. I'm definitely not that good at this game right now at staying alive. I think it's harder to stay alive in this game than any other COD, actually, just because of the movement mechanics. So it's kind of interesting to see that they brought something that challenging to get, and it's definitely going to be something I'm going to be going for. I don't know, maybe I'll do a vicious medal with every gun series in this game, but I highly doubt I could get a DNA bomb with every single gun in this game. That would be just the ultimate challenge. But anyways, guys, let me know what you think in this game. Let me know if you're enjoying it. I know a lot of people are. Let me know like your positives to this game. Maybe your negatives too, which might appear in my next commentary about this for the negatives. Because there are definitely a ton of negatives to this game. It's definitely not perfect. They have fixed a lot of things since day one, though. If I did this these two videos like right at launch, like a couple days after launch, there'd definitely be a lot more negatives to it because there was just like some crazy lag at the start of this game. But right now it seems pretty great, pretty solid. I'm actually at second prestige right now. So yeah, I've just been playing the shit out of this game. I mean, some people are like already max prestige, so I don't even know how the fuck like what they're doing. But yeah, this game, it's really enjoyable. So anyways, guys, I'll see you guys in the next video. Remember to smash that like button if you enjoyed. Peace. Have a good one.